My name is Kangkwan Ni. I am an assistant professor at Harvard University. I was awarded a Backman Young Investigator in 2015 for the research Ultracold Molecules for Quantum Chemistry and Molecular Assembly. I would like to thank the Arnold and Mabel Backman Foundation for such a wonderful support. Dr. Backman was a scientist, an entrepreneur, a philanthropist, and a civil servant. Throughout his life, he made ingenious scientific instruments that benefited a large number of scientific communities. Furthermore, his invention found critical presence in the lives of people then and now. Beyond his scientific, technical, and philanthropic work, he is truly an inspiring figure who impacts how I choose to continue my scientific career. In particular, his example motivated me to examine my career critically and find ways to make more immediate contributions to the society with our scientific findings and scholarship. The BYI Award allowed my lab to take bold new steps in quantum control of molecules. Our goal is to harness molecular resources for quantum applications such as simulations and computations. When we think about chemistry, we usually think about making molecules. Typically, molecules made from A and B, for example, start with an ensemble of A and an ensemble of B. Through stochastic encounters of A and B, some AB molecules are formed. In my lab, we push such a reaction to the most indivisible limit to gain total control, where we take exactly one A and one B and forge a bond to make an AB molecule. Such a conceptual simple experiment took a whole lab and many years to accomplish. In our case, A and B are a cesium and a sodium atoms, and the molecule that we made is a sodium-cesium molecule. To do so, we first cool down a gas of cesium and sodium atoms to about 100 microkelvin, that is 0.0001 Kelvin above absolute zero. Then we use two tightly focused laser beams as optical tweezers. One grabs a cesium atom and one grabs a sodium atom from the gas. We then cool down the single atoms further in the optical tweezer confining potentials to their quantum mechanical limits. Afterwards, we move the tweezer slowly so the atoms can stay at the bottom of the confining tweezer potentials during the transport without heating. This act is much like using a spoon to transport an egg at the fastest possible speed without spilling. After that, we merge the two atoms into a single optical tweezer. From there, we derive two different colors of yet another laser to pair two atoms into a molecular bound state. Because we start with one sodium atom and one cesium atom, we're able to create exactly one molecule after such a process. Conceptually, this is quite similar to this picture. In the future, we're interested to parallelize such a well-controlled process to create an array of single molecules by building each molecule in parallel from single atoms. What does that mean? These single molecules are like Legos for us to assemble and to understand more complicated systems based on quantum principles from the bottom up. In addition, these molecules are ideal quantum bits, or qubits for short, that can be entangled to perform quantum logic gates for computations. Our research effort, generously supported by the BYI Award, opens up an exciting new direction of molecular quantum physics and chemistry. And now, many labs around the world are following our footsteps. In closing, I want to thank Dr. Backman and the Arnold and Mabel Backman Foundation again for valuing the tremendous potentials from young researchers. I feel very lucky to be supported at an early stage of my career, and I feel very fortunate to work with young, energetic, and talented students and postdocs to drive new breakthroughs. And by continuing to think outside the box, beyond any traditional boundary, I am looking forward to future scientific discoveries. Thank you.